Welcome to season two of the Bumper Crops series. I'm Damon Smith, Extension Field Crops Pathologist with the University of Wisconsin-Madison.
Rodrigo Worley, Extension Weed Scientist with the University of Wisconsin-Madison.
So Rodrigo, we're here in the 2022 field season. We're trying to get things started and it's cold. And things look like they're going to be delayed in terms of planting. And folks are very interested in rye cover crops and terminating rye cover crops. But we have a complication this year in the fact that it's cool. So what are your recommendations as we move into this sort of different field season than we've experienced over the last couple?
Right now, if you recall a year ago when we were talking about the same topic, termination of rye, it was a much different scenario. Right. We were dry, we were warm, and here we are cold and wet. So every year, it's different. So farmers are calling in now, they want to plant that crop. They have the cereal rye cover crop. That rye has not grown a whole lot this year. If you want to see the benefits, especially from a weed suppression standpoint, you want to have more biomass accumulation. They're calling in to say, look, I'm ready to plant. Do I spray now? What do I do? If you're ready to plant, go ahead, plant. If you're planting corn, terminate that rye as soon as possible. Okay, when terminating that rye, glyphosate is going to be your main option for chemical termination of the cereal rye cover crop, Damon. So when spraying that glyphosate, make sure we have warmer temperatures when we have 50 degrees or above for effective uptake and translocation. We're in a year where we cannot afford a respray scenario.
Right.
Also be mindful what you're spraying with that glyphosate. For instance, last year some folks mixed glyphosate with atrazine. That atrazine burned the rye. We didn't have good uptake and translocation of that glyphosate, which became a problem. So again, be mindful of those things. If you're going in with soybeans, plant the beans, and then you can wait a little longer to terminate that rye. Those are recommendations. What are your thoughts, Damon?
Yeah, I think soybeans, we have a little more flexibility in the system for sure. My concern, I think, this year is planting corn into that rye, you know. And we know from some work done here in Wisconsin, also at Iowa State, that we really need to have a, you know, 14-day minimum on termination to plant that corn and to avoid some of the pythium problems and pathogen problems that we would run into. So certainly a challenge on the corn side, but folks just need to be aware and try to be a little flexible, it sounds like, this year, and be mindful of the shortages on chemical.
Absolutely. And the weather, temperature, and it's been extremely windy too. So when spraying out there, make sure you pick a good day to do that.
Great. Thanks, Rodrigo. If you'd like to learn more about termination of rye or cover crops in general, feel free to visit the Nutrient and Pest Management website at ipcm.wisc.edu or get in touch with your local extension agent.